about 15 years, I've been a recording engineer. A good audio engineer is extremely important to have because they're trained better. Their ears are trained better. Anyone can come into a recording session and press record. But it takes a certain finesse, and it takes a very critical ear that is developed over time in order to be a good recording engineer.
I'm a keyboardist, and I also play guitar, I also play drums, and I also sing. I think it really helps to be both a performer and an engineer because you listen better. You're more in tune with what's going on both sides of the glass.
So that'll take care of some of your low end?
I was a musician from the get-go, and I had a very kind high school music teacher. I was going to apply to music school, and he told me what a good scientist I would be. And so I took the hint and went and pursued science instead of music as a profession. But it's always been an interest of mine, playing music. Well, I've been working with a good friend and collaborator, Dave Headlam, at the Eastman School of Music for about 15 or 16 years now on research at the intersection of engineering and music.
So it's very much a sonic branding sort of thing going on here, as opposed to just sound.
We decided to test the waters at the undergraduate level, and so we invented this program. We have a huge number of students here at the U of R who are interested in music, and they're drawn to the university because of the proximity of the Eastman School of Music. And so if there's anywhere in the world where you can combine engineering and music studies, Rochester is really an optimal place.
The students in my class currently come from all different backgrounds. There's some engineering students, there's composition students from Eastman, there's some literature students. There's a good balance, and it's actually a good energy in the class to have so many different disciplines in the class.
I think what distinguishes a good audio engineer is someone who has a great set of ears and also has a skill set that's in the technical side that they can bring along to the program. It's not just one or the other, you really have to have both.
It's fundamentally the same creative instinct that makes people want to do engineering and do music. It's a nice combination of rules and creative input, and engineering is a lot like that.
We're asking the students to learn many different disciplines so that they can be ready to be in audio production or in the software development or in hardware development.
The field's definitely still changing. It evolves partially based on the technology, partially based on the demands of what the output is. With sound design, you could do anything from movies and film and television and radio to games. So there's a lot of industries that draw from this skill, and it really gives the students a lot of opportunity to explore all of those.
A production of the University of Rochester. Please visit us online and subscribe to our channel for more videos.